Nick Lachey. Present, right, that's you.
Well, you have, and I've always marveled at this from afar, and now from near, you've really managed to stay in the mix, stay working, stay popular among people of all ages.
I'm like a bad itch. I never truly go away. I'm always lingering there.
I guess if you want to stay relevant like that, you do have to do the whatever the kids are doing, right?
No, stay true to who you are, right? I mean, no matter what you do in life, no matter what, you know, be true to who you are, stay true to who you are, and I tend to think good things happen.
Who are you? Give me three things. If you say stay true to who you are, true to what, and what?
Hardworking,
mm-hmm.
Humble, blessed.
Bam! Hardworking, humble, and
am
blessed.
Am I humble that I said blessed? If you call yourself hardworking, does that make you humble?
I think if you call yourself humble, you're not humble, frankly.
Really? Yeah. All right, so let me go. Hardworking.
No, it's out. It's already done. Print.
Can't take it back?
Nope. Famously early on, you did the Newlyweds, and then mm-hmm. you did the one with your brother in the bar.
I think it's perfect.
It started with a little dream, and through a lot of hard work, we actually got to realize that dream.
Two, three. Oh.
It's a big question, but can you explain for me the difference in you between the guy who showed up 10 years ago in the Newlyweds and the guy who's behind the bar on the show now? Because I assume with the word reality, like, you are keeping it real.
I mean, I'd say hopefully a little older and wiser. Things hurt where they didn't hurt before, you know, back in those days. But I at least hope that the core of who I am is not that different from then. I'd at least like to think that I've tried to consistently stay the same person and not, you know, not that you don't grow and evolve, but you never want to let anything take you to a different place as a person, you know. And
do you ever watch them back to back?
You'd be shocked to know I do not.
You don't watch them at all.
I don't watch them. Yeah. I think it's you know, doing them is one thing. Watching and kind of that, I think that can mess you up a little bit.
How you feeling?
Nervous.
It's too late to turn back.
What are some hidden talents that nobody knows about?
That I have? Oh gosh.
I have so many.
I feel like what you've done in reality TV, that you have no more secrets and everyone knows your talent or your talentless, you know, parts of your life. Everyone knows I sing.
You're 90 years old.
I
mean,
I'm not like a great dancer on the side. I'm not like, I don't have any. I like crossword puzzles. Is that a good? Is that a hidden talent?
I don't know. Are you good at them?
Not really that good at them.
But that's not a talent.
I don't have any.
Really?
Apparently,
I'm sorry.
Apparently, I can make kids. That's
you can make kids.
There you go. Hidden talent. Who knew?
Well, and good ones, right?
So far, I'm keeping them.
Oh my God, you have three. Are you planning to continue?
I am not actually. I think that's three is a good number.
I really was gunning for three, and my husband was like, "Are you out of your mind?" I mean, we were at two, and it's listen, not to complain because it's the best, but it's hard to keep
the difference up. Between two and three is a pretty big jump.
When you stop being man on man,
yeah,
right?
You're
they've got
straight zone defense. Like this the whole time.
Well, and with the dogs, right? So you've got a, what do you poo?
Yorkie doodle or Yorkie poodle or whatever, the Yorkie poodle.
It is a Yorkie doodle, yeah. And you know it. But listen, I admire all these manly men who say things like, oh yes, I have a Yorkie doodle. It's a ridiculous name.
Well, that's why I call him a Porky. He's a poodle Yorkie mix, so we call him a Porky.
That is way better.
It sounds much more manly than Yorkie poo.
I have a Porky. Well, you know, it also sounds like you could be saying something dirty a little bit.
Well, a little bit, but only if you were alive in the 80s and remember, you know, that movie.
I'm not old enough to remember that movie. Continue.
So, tell me all about it.
Well, I know that you are here, in fact, Nick Lachey, to speak about animals.
I am.
All right, well, let's hit it.
Yeah, I'm here to talk about Wookiee and something he went through. I guess it's probably about 5 years ago. Now he's going to be 10 this month, which I find very hard to believe. So
time flies.
But we had gone out of the country. He stayed with some friends of ours, and basically we came back from vacation. He was just itching uncontrollably, and like to the point where we had to put the cone on his head because he kept licking it and irritating it, and he was losing his hair.
I'm sorry, I didn't realize we were talking about this. Is awful.
Well, yeah, it's not a good thing, but
no,
there's a happy ending. Every story is a happy ending.
Okay, we'll get to
a happy
it.
Ending.
I'm kidding.
So we went to our vet and said, what in the world is going on?
What
and
in
she
the world?
Said, I think you may have an allergy situation. So she prescribed Apoquel for him, which almost instantly took care of the itching and took care of the problem. I know a lot of people out there have similar situations with their dogs. They're worried about it. You know, it could be just something routine, but it could be something bigger.
What was he allergic to?
We don't know. It could have been something environmental. It could have been something he was eating.
If you had an itching situation yourself, would
you
take Apoquel?
I do have one right now, actually.
Really?
It's right over here.
Yeah. Okay. Feel free to, okay.
It happens all the time. I only shower once a week. See, I felt good, actually.
You did it?
Yeah.
I'll bet. I know. We don't really itch each other's faces quite enough, do we?
No, it's
for comfort.
Something about that personal space thing that people have issue with. I don't know.
I really can't understand. Thank you so much for coming
Thanks
to talk,
Stu. Thanks for having me.
Cheers.
It.